Hello, and welcome back to my new video. Today, I will be giving you my 5 best tips on how to use the console in CSGO. First of all, I will quickly show you how to enable the console in CSGO. First, go to Steam, Steam Library, CSGO, Properties, and Set Launch Options. Here you want to type in -console and click OK. You can now start CSGO. If you have done this correctly, then the console will pop up as soon as you start CSGO. Now go into your options menu, keyboard and mouse settings, and scroll all the way down to toggle console. Here you can assign a key you want to open and close the console with. And that's it. Tip number 1. The search feature. Currently, there are over 2,400 commands that you can use in the console. So instead of googling every command you want to use, you can actually search for the command you want inside the console itself. So for example, if you want to kick all the bots on your server, you would search for bot, and then press space in the console. This will now show you a list of the first commands with the word bot inside it. But we couldn't find what we searched for, so we need to be more specific. So let's add kick and space again. And look, here we have the command we're looking for. bot_kick. You can also press tab to autocomplete the commands. This feature is very useful if you don't remember that command but what it does instead. Or if you're looking for a new command in a category, for example commands that you can use with bots. Tip number 2. Categories. Most of the commands can be divided into categories. Some of them are MP_, which are commands that affect the game rules in the game, like time, money, restarting rounds and team limit, etc. And SV_, that affect changes to the values and properties on the server, like acceleration, infinite ammo and showing bullet impact. And also CL_, that affect changes to your client, like for example your crosshair, HUD and view model, etc. This makes it so that commands are really easy to search and find. So if you, for example, are interested in entities, there is a category for them called ENT_. Tip number 3. Common designations. There are many numbers and symbols that have a greater meaning than life. For example, 1 and 0, which also means on and off, for many cases in the console. If you aren't a filthy console gamer, you probably knew this already. And also plus and minus, which also means toggle on and off, but for when you're pressing a key on your keyboard instead. And the symbol semicolon can be used to link up more than just one command at a time. For example, if you both want to drop an M4A4 and an AK-47 at the same time. This is especially useful if you want to bind a key to do multiple commands at once. Tip number 4. Binds. If you want to bind a key to a command, use bind and then the key and then the command you want to use. For example, like this. So you bind the key M to say hello in chat. You will need to have quotation marks around the key and the command if you want to have more commands in the bind, like in this example. Tip number 5. Google and trial and error. My last tip is not to be afraid of testing new commands and typing in the wrong inputs, because the best way to learn new commands is by testing with trial and error. And if something doesn't work, you can always Google the command or ask me, because someone has most likely already figured out how to use the command. But in worst case, the game will crash and you will have to restart it. If you are interested to learn some stuff about console commands, I will link you a few useful websites in the description. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have any tips that wasn't shown in this video, please share them in the comments and I will do my best to respond. I would also like to thank for all the support lately, with all the nice comments and new people that have enjoyed my content. But that is all for now, and don't forget to have fun!